Hi, hope you're doing well. This video we are going to discuss about Netscaler traffic management and virtual server configuration. So the detailed agenda is, first we'll discuss about the traffic management and virtual server types. So there are different types of virtual servers in Netscaler which we can create. We'll discuss all of them, and after that we'll create only the load balancing virtual server, and we will discuss about load balancing methods, and we'll show you how they work. Then we will configure the session persistence. We'll discuss about that, and the X forwarder for is nothing but if your client says the application team want to see the end user IP, you know, this is what X forwarder for. So this, we will show you how to configure that. And the last one is we'll discuss the expressions and policies in the Netscaler. We have three servers. Let's say server one, server two, and server three, and each server has two directories running on it. Let's say slash home and slash web. Second server only has home, and the Netscaler is there. So let's say that this portal.company.com, the website, is running on all these three servers. You know, to provide redundancy, what we generally do, we load balance the traffic, right? So what Netscaler will do, whenever the user requests are coming to this website called portal.company.com, it will load balance the traffic across all the three servers. So that is what it is. So this is the simple load balancing method. Now we'll talk about what is the load balancing methods, like round robin and least connection. This is very important to know. Round robin means when the first request comes, it will be sent to one, second to second, third to third. On the other hand, when we are discussing about least connection, let's say that there are 10 sessions connected to one, 10 sessions connected to server 2, 10 sessions connected to server 3. And during this time, let's say the server 3 has rebooted, you know, then what happens? The 10 sessions which are in server 3, Netscaler will automatically balance them to 1 and 2. So in that case, what happens? 15, 15 here. Now the server came up. So if it is typical round robin method, what happens? There are 15 here, the next one will be 16, 16, and then 1. You know, it is not fair, right? Because this is not loaded. So what least connection will do when this thing happened, whenever the server reboots and it sees that there is no load on this, whenever the next request comes, all the requests it will try to put on this. Let's say if it has 15, it will try to send all the next 15 sessions to the third server so that the load will be balanced. This is called least connection. Now let's discuss about GSLB. GSLB is nothing but, let's say that you have two data centers, one in US, one in Europe, and you have the same website called portal.company.com, let's say example Google or something, you know. So when you want to have the same website, and let's say if your user is coming from US, you want them to send to US, and if your user is coming from Europe, you want them to send to Europe, you will configure something called GSLB. What GSLB will do, Netscaler will talk to each other. They will check where the user is coming from with the DNS record, and if they are coming from US, they will send the traffic to US servers. If they are coming from Europe, it will be sent back to Europe servers. This is called GSLB. It's nothing but global server load balancing. Now the third thing is content switching. Content switching is nothing but, let's say you have a website called portal.company.com, and on this website there are directories, right? Slash home, slash web. So as you can see here, server 1, 2 and 3 has home, while as only 1 and 3 has web. So what happens if a user goes to with a normal load balancing method and put portal.company.com and let's say slash web, whenever they hit this server here, what happens is the website is not there. So they are not able to access it. For this reason, we will do something called content switching. What content switching will do? Let's say that whenever the slash home is coming, we will create a separate load balancer virtual server for that, and we will tell them slash home is 1, 2, 3. We'll create a group of servers, I would say 1, 2, 3. Let's say if the traffic is coming to slash web, we will tell them that the traffic will go to 1 and 3 only. This is called content switching, guys. It's very simple. Let's move on. Now there is the third type of virtual servers which we'll configure in Netscaler is called AAA virtual servers. AAA virtual servers is mostly for authenticity. Let's say you have a website called portal.company.com and user is accessing that portal, and generally what happens, your portal websites has username as maybe AD and RSA authentication, you will authenticate. For example, you have many websites which require the same kind of authentication. So it is not good that you ask, you know, you are prompting user every time for username password, right? So let's say in that case, what happens? You will create something called AAA authentication virtual server. This virtual server job is to authenticate AD and RSA. So how the traffic flow will be is, let's say the user is accessing portal.company.com. The traffic will be sent back to auth, means in the website, it will change to auth. Then that the Netscaler, the authentication virtual server will authenticate against username, AD and RSA, or let's say you have only AD, it will be only one then. It will authenticate with whatever you have, and then it will send the traffic back to the original website. And this original website, because it has authentication, it takes the token, it sends the traffic back to the backend servers with the authentication token. So for this to work, the backend servers also need to accept the authentication token. Now let's say that you have another website called intranet.company.com requires similar authentication. Then what happens? When user goes to this website, they no need authentication because you are already authenticated in the same browser. So they will directly go inside the application. So the rule is authenticate once and within the browser session, means within the same browser, it will provide SSO to multiple websites. This is the use case of AAA authentication virtual server, mostly for single sign-on feature. Now the last type of virtual server which we create in Netscaler is Netscaler Gateway virtual server. Actually, what is Netscaler Gateway? For us to simply understand, this is mostly used for VPNs, intranet portals, and VDI, mobility, these kind of things, right? It kind of provides a gateway feature. So what is the difference between gateway and normal virtual server? Normal virtual server, you have load balance, one or two servers. But in gateway virtual server, let's say we talk about example of VDIs, you have 1000 VDI. And the, when you are accessing, let's say either might be a Horizon or Zendesktop, what happens? They will give the actual VDI IP to the Netscaler and it will be translated to a token and sent to user, right? So the Netscaler will talk to the respective VDI, means it's a pool. Gateway is generally you are accessing a pool of services in the backend, in a mature way and secure way. Same thing with if you have a VPN service, internal servers you will access. Now we finished with theory. We'll go and see the Netscaler configuration, how we'll do the load balancing and other stuff. Let me explain my environment here, what we are trying to do. We have two websites called, it's a home page. Let's say a simple website which I had created. Let's say it is a home page. It is hosted on two servers, 216 and 217. So let's refresh this and check it is working. So yeah, it is working on server one, and refresh, it is working on server two. So now we are aware that our website is running on 443 and it is having a page called home page on server one and server two. Now let's go and configure the load balancing virtual server in Netscaler. So as you know, Netscaler, you log in, go to configuration, traffic management, load balancing. There are three things we need to do. Configuring load balancing is very simple. One, create servers. Servers means the backend servers, means your actual websites. These are backend servers. Then you will create something called service groups or services. See, both are same, but in service, what happens? You will manage these each and every server individually. But I don't like that. I like to manage them as a group. So I always prefer using them as a group. So once you want to do any changes, all the changes you manage on the group and it will be reflected to all the servers. So that is service group. Now, after creating a service group means it's a pool of servers. So you have two servers, right? You will add the two servers to the service group. So you are telling them, these are my servers. Then you will create a virtual server. What is virtual server? Virtual server is what actually the user will talk to. If you have any confusion about what is this virtual server, what is VIP, what is SNIP, what is Netscaler IP, this is called Netscaler IP, please refer to the link in the description below. It is really helpful. Please have a look at it. Now, virtual server is nothing but what the user will talk to, right? So now let's go ahead and create the servers. So my server names are, let's say, click on add, click on server, give any server name. Typically, it is your actual name. You click create. Then what you will do, you will click on add. You put server 02, my second server, and I'll say 217, right? So what I'm doing, I created two servers, 216 and 217. These are my backend servers where the website is running. Now I'll go to the service groups. So home page, service group, right? So what I will do, my backend server is actually SSL, right? I will click on the SSL and say okay. No need to do anything. Just click on the server, server based, and then select the two servers and port 443, right? It is running on 4, leave everything defaults, save okay, and then fine. So as you can see here, the home page service group is up. Up means it is, the backend servers are listening. Let's say in your case, if it is down, means the communication from the SNIP to your actual backend application servers is not open. That's the only reason. Now go to the virtual server. But before going to the virtual server, you need to understand one thing. It is an SSL, right? But I don't have SSL certificate. So you need to request your team for SSL certificate. I have it already. So let us install. They gave me an PFX certificate. I will install them. Go to server certificate, certificate, server certificates. Now I will install and say certificate key pair name SF certificate, and I will choose local, means local PC desktop. I received a PFX file. When you receive PFX file, you will get an import password, right? You need to put the password, click install. It's installed. So the SF certificate is installed. The second thing, whenever we install a certificate, we need to do is link the certificate. Click on the certificate, click link, then it will show the root certificates. If it is not showing, just click on install and install the root certificate. In my case, it is already there. That's why it is showing here. So linking is done. Now go back to load balancing, traffic manager, load balancing, virtual servers. Now I'll create a virtual server. SF web site virtual server. This is my name. I select SSL. By the way, you can select, there are traffic types. You can select HTTP. Generally, we use three mostly. One is HTTP. HTTP is for any web traffic. TCP is, if you don't know what is a backend traffic, your application team gives some random port 8000, 2000 and all. Use TCP as a method, both in service group and the virtual server. Now, let's say that in your case, you know the backend traffic is SSL. You always select SSL. Now, what is SSL, difference between SSL and SSL bridge? In SSL, you will do SSL offloading on the NetScaler. But SSL bridge, we will not do the SSL offloading on the NetScaler. We will take the SSL traffic, we will hand it over to the backend server. Like in the case of your Zen Mobile, you will do this. So let's say my 192.168.2.213 is my virtual server IP. Means my users will talk to this IP. Now click OK. It's very simple. It is asking, as you can see here, server service and service group. We created service group. Click on it. Click here and select the service group we created. Select bind. That's it. It's very simple. Click OK. Then because we selected the SSL, it will ask for certificate. If you select a TCP or HTTP, it will not ask you. Click on server certificate. Select and select the certificate which you installed. Okay, and then continue. That's it. We are done. Okay. As you can see here, my website is also up, right? It is showing up. Means all the services are up. Now, by default, the load balancing method is least connection. My website name is sf.sslab.com, and what I am doing, it is pinging, right? 2.213. The DNS record is created pointing to the virtual server. So I'll take this name. I'll go to the website. So what I will do, I will try to open the website. Yes, accept. As you can see, you went to server one, right? Now I'm refreshing. You went to server two, right? Server one, server two, server one, server two, server one, server two. You see this? So now let's say that sometimes, based on the load, it is doing kindly looking like a round robin, but because we don't have much load for testing, so that's why it's like this. Now let's jump into the next one, the configuration part. Let's say I want to show you in real time what happens. Let's say in your case, select server 2 and say disable, means we are disabling the backend server. You see, so server 2 is disabled. Service group C partially up, but the virtual server will be fully up, means your virtual server is up, right? Now you refresh the website, you will always go to server 1 only, even after multiple refresh, because server 2 is down, because Netscale is taking care of it. Now go to servers and enable the service. As you can see here, it will automatically come up, right? Good. Now after doing any configuration, please click on this to save the configuration. This is very important, right? Because if you didn't save by mistake, if Netscaler reboots, you know, you will lose all the configuration, because it will save in the running configuration. Now let's discuss about the load balancing methods, how to change. Open the virtual server, go to the method. As you can see, default least connection will be there. You can change it to whatever method you want. There are a lot of methods, you know, source, destination, IP hash, a lot of things, but most of the people will use either round robin or least connection. So let's say we'll use round robin now, you know. Now click on done. Now what happens, you can see our website method is round robin, means it will go to server 1 and server 2. Now let's discuss about the persistence. What is persistence? Persistence means, let's say that your application is something where you will work on the, your user works in that application, inside the application, like say for half an hour, 1 hour. You don't want, you know, the request will be swapping from one server to another server. So to make persistence, this is always good. Click on persistence on the right hand side, right? It will be added. Click on source IP. Mostly all your applications, you will use source IP based persistence. Let's say to put 20, it's for 20 minutes or 60 minutes. So if I do this persistence on the virtual server, what happens, I click on done, is you will see here persistence source IP is there. So whenever my request is coming, now let's say I'm load balancing, right? See, even though I'm refreshing, I have two servers, it's not going to second server, because why? I have a persistence. So for this client IP, it is saying for 20 minutes, try to stick to one server. What happens if the server goes down? Of course, it will go to another server, you know, automatically. But, you know, the persistence will make sure the session is stick to one server, so that user will get more performance or more experience, I would say. This is persistence. Now, the last one, I would say X forwarder for. So I'll copy this X forwarder for. What is X forwarder for? Let's say my backend servers, the application team says, I want to know what is my client IP. Let's say from this client IP I am coming, right? If application want to know end user IP, you know, the PC IP from where they are coming, some applications have dependency, then go to service groups, the same service group you created, click on it, go to the settings, click edit here, and there is something called client IP. When you say client IP, the header will come, just paste X dot hyphen forwarded hyphen for, that's it. Have a look, X hyphen forwarded for. Click on OK and then click OK. Then what happens, whenever I am coming from any client is coming, the client IP will be sent to the backend servers. This is X forwarded for. Now we are done with the load balancing of virtual servers. We'll show you another important thing, which is session policies and policies and expression. What is a policy and what is the expression? Very simple. I'll show you with one example, existing example. You are doing a session profile here, means let's say this is for VDI. You did a lot of changes here. You want these settings to be applied to your virtual server based on some condition, right? You have two. What is the condition? Now the condition is the expression that you will create inside a policy, and you will apply this policy to your virtual server. So what happens is, now this policy you created, in that the expression says the request HTTP request header contains user agent and Citrix receiver is there, means sent to OS. Means what we are talking about is, it is with Citrix receiver you connect directly. So let's say if the customer or end user client is coming without Citrix receiver, dot not, means without, go to the second profile. So this is called policy and expression, and you will apply the policy to the respective servers where you want to do. That's it, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope you like these videos. Please like, subscribe to this channel and share with your friends. And most importantly, try to finish all the trainings in this series. Thank you.